Hello and welcome in to another week of the USL Tactics Show, where I wanted to discuss the Charleston Battery's defensive struggles in 2021, especially compared to 2020. As you can see in the numbers, their shots on target allowed, and especially their goals allowed, have really suffered. So I wanted to start off by just showing a really decent clip of their defending from last season. That four-man midfield is shifting really well. Zeke Lewis and another forward are pressing up high. But when Atlanta really enters into possession, you can see them shifting back, getting into that solid positioning, owning the middle of the field. Compare that to this sequence against Hartford, where they're played over the top. Neither of the two lines behind the forwards are really communicating well, and it's going to end in a chance that Hartford converts. Again, you're going to see a turnover here, and then in the sequence that follows that turnover, there's just such poor communication. No one's taking ownership and closing down and communicating. And those themes persisted in the most recent match against Charlotte. Now, Charlotte is a really effective attacking side who you have to close down. There are so many players who really give you a threat, and you're not going to see much of that in the following clips. Marvo is able to play a really nice pass there that leads to a shot. In this sequence, again, it's another turnover, and again, Charlotte's able to break amidst some really poor communication where no one takes ownership and marks the really dangerous players that Charlotte brings to the table. So you think about some of these overcommittals, some of these turnovers, and then a lack of marking at other times, and you really get the picture of general disorganization that hasn't been characteristic of a Charleston team that returned a lot of players. And yes, this is a really tough Atlantic division that's full of talented teams and a talented attacking units, but this level of disorganization is such a difficult thing to overcome. And to me, it explains why this Charleston team will be missing out on the playoffs.